Darling, you send me.
All right, we're at the station. We're about to leave Netherlands. We've just got some breakfast to go. We've got our bags here, all ready to go. Our train comes in 9:28, so about half an hour. Then we get to Bruges about 1:30. We've got to change in Brussels for a bit, but not enough time to actually look around. Overall, Netherlands has been really, really good. Like I said before, Amsterdam, definitely overrated. If you do come, try to stay out of Amsterdam. The overall, I'll give Netherlands as a country 7.5 out of 10. So yeah, overall, good little trip to Netherlands. Good start to the trip, and hopefully it continues to get even better. We then arrived in Bruges after what was a long, long train journey. We finally arrived. It was my second time coming here, so I kind of knew what to expect. But yeah, overall, all looked really nice place. Saw the main little sites, the castle area, and then we headed to get some Belgian waffles. The queue was long, but it was worth it. Belgian waffles with chocolate sauce, you just can't beat it. Right, day four. Welcome back to day four of the vlog. We're in Bruges today. This is my second time here actually. Came about 4 or 5 months ago. But a lot nicer this time because, as you can see behind me, it's spring, so all the flowers are in full bloom. I'm gonna walk around. We just had some Belgian waffles and chocolate sauce, so that was very nice. Right, we are on the street of Bruges. Unfortunately, we tried to find somewhere for dinner. We looked literally everywhere to find somewhere cheap, but no, there's nothing. It's too expensive, this city. So we have went for the local Belgian option of McDonald's. Good news, we've got a Liverpool game at 8 o'clock we're gonna go watch. We found a good pub to watch it at. And then a Belgian beer tasting at 10 o'clock. Hopefully meet some people, actually be social for once. We might actually make a friend or two. So hopefully it should be a good evening. And it's an early start tomorrow. Haven't got much time here in Bruges. This is the most expensive McDonald's we've ever been to. For filet fish, it's €8. For a McChicken, it was what? How much?
£8.50
for a McChicken. I mean, in England, McChickens are like two quid. It's €9 for a meal. Alright, most expensive McDonald's. How much did it come to? Like 10, 12 euros for all of it. Alright, welcome to day five now. I can't believe it's day five. It's felt like at least a week, but we're in back at Bruges station, going to Brussels about the third time. I don't know how long. It's both our first times in Germany, so really looking forward to it. Should be good. Overall, Bruges is good, but the hostel, I don't know. A couple of lads got back at like 3 a.m, they were shouting and screaming. The guy next to me's alarm went off every 10 minutes, which is an absolute nightmare. But let's go on to Germany for a new country, new experience, and a bit of new culture. We've made it to Cologne. We thought, while we're in Germany, we're pretty hungry, so we're gonna go find some German sausages, bit of German beer, make our way back in Central. And just like that, we were in Cologne, Germany. Straight at the station, we saw the incredible and world-famous Cologne Cathedral. I couldn't quite believe it at first, what a sight it was. Then as per usual, we walked around for a bit until we found our first German lunch, some German doner kebab. What better way to start the Germany trip than with some doner meat? And then as the cathedral was so impressive, we headed back inside and it was even better with all the wonderful stained glass artworks. Honestly, one of the coolest things I've ever seen in Europe. 10 out of 10, would recommend.
Updating the vlog from the hostel. This is our third room. I haven't really shown you the hostels we've been staying in, but if you look at this one, we've got 3 bunks here. In terms of Cologne, there isn't too much to do now. I feel like we've done the main thing, the Cologne Cathedral, which is incredible. We've got a recommendation for our local German place for dinner. I think more than a day here in Cologne, you'd be bored.
Alright, dinner done. We went to Hams and Gluck actually, which we get all over Singapore. Probably the most expensive meal we've had all trip so far. It came to like €22. We thought, why not? We're in Germany first night, we'll try some German food. It was good, we got a burger. But now we're on the way to back to the cathedral. We're gonna try to sit in the square. Hopefully it's a nice sunset tonight, because it's only 8 o'clock, so we've got a lot of time before, but we have to go back to the hostel. Overall, it's been a good day here in Cologne.
Another day, another city. It was another early start, and this time we were headed to Heidelberg. I'd heard really good things about it being a historic city set in nature, and that couldn't have been any truer. In true Harry Nelson fashion, we walked down the city until we found our second German dish, some currywurst for lunch. And it was actually really, really spicy. We then continued on our walk and got lost, but it was so worth it, as we ended up climbing the hill and finding some old ruins of a castle and getting the most spectacular views across the whole of Heidelberg. Honestly, incredible.
We're currently walking the streets of Heidelberg. We're on the way to the old bridge, but so far really enjoying it. It's got a very like local small town feel, much more different to Cologne, much better than Cologne actually. So really, really nice. Hopefully Rothenburg is something similar to this. All right, welcome back to the vlog. We're in the hostel in Heidelberg. In the kitchen, something new. So we've been eating out a lot, and we thought, why not save a bit of money, be a bit healthier. So today, It's going to be a new part on the Europe travel vlog. We're going to be cooking. Today's menu, Lana, we have a classic you've seen on my channel in Belgium, but the old
sausage pasta.
She came up to like 11 euros for two of us. He's already on it. But we've got tomato pasta with a little,
the Heidelberg Greek salad.
Hopefully it's tasty and we don't get food poisoning. Alright, I'm back on the voiceovers for day 8, which was one of the craziest but best days of the trip, with a pretty wild ending. The weather was pretty miserable, but we decided to hit up the food market nonetheless, and there's almost too much food to choose from. But we continued on the German food quest and picked up some bratwurst today. To be honest, I preferred the currywurst from the day before. And then the day took a pretty wild turn. We decided to go to one of the most famous breweries in Munich, where they serve liters of beers and steins. The queue was so long, but there's nothing better to do, so we stuck it out, and we were escorted in and sat next to an old, lovely German couple. And we just started drinking, listened to music, and basically didn't stop drinking. And so as you're probably noticing in these clips, we get progressively more and more drunk. It was such a good laugh though, and the guy started telling us about his life stories, although we couldn't understand a word he was saying. We just had a lovely moment in a beer hall, all a bit out of it, and exchanging our life stories with one another. One of the most memorable parts of the whole trip was this. Oh yeah, and here's me trying to explain how I vlog, but I couldn't get the right words out. Just enjoy these following clips.
Is you take the video and you put it on social media.
Outrage.
Or anything like that.
Alright, welcome back to the vlog. We're in Munich. We've just had the most incredible experience. Went to a beer hall called Hofbrauhaus. We met some incredible people. They're like a couple of 6 years old. Walked around, we saw the cathedral, we saw the square, but we've seen so many of them, we were a bit bored, so we're like, let's do something else. So we decided to go to the beer house, the brewery. There's not too much to see. I mean, the weather today has been pretty bad. It was raining, it was cold for most of the day. So yeah, overall, Munich is kind of what you expect Germany to be like. So far, Germany trip has definitely taken a skyrocket tonight.
All right, welcome back to the vlog. We're on our way back into Munich. We went back, had a little bit of a nap. Farmer enjoyed a little sleepage. So yeah, we're gonna get some dinner on the hunt for some shit still. We found a good place that's recommended by locals. So I think we're enjoying Munich a lot. Probably our favorite city we've been in so far. Should be a good little dinner, bit of shit still. Can't beat it.